Welcome to the CS Suite Marketplace webinar series. Marketplace offers fresh perspectives and strategies presented monthly by knowledge specialists from Conference 39 Platinum and Gold sponsors. I'm Lisa Collins with CS Week, and I'll be joined today by Kelly Service, Marketing Head, Strategic Marketing, ENU North America with Wipro, and he'll be your moderator and questions facilitator in the Q&A segment. Mark your calendars for CS Week and Conference 40, Automa Horizon, April 25th to the 29th at the Phoenix Convention Center in Phoenix, Arizona. Watch your email and our social media channels for registration information. This program will be recorded and available for playback along with our other archived presentations later this afternoon. You will find it by selecting Marketplace under the webinars drop-down menu on the csweek.org homepage. Attendees are encouraged to upload questions to the Q&A panel as they arise. However, all questions will be held until after the presentation for the Q&A segment. Please ensure that you address your questions to all panelists so that both Kelly and I will be able to see the questions as well as the speakers. Today's webinar is Digital Roadmap for the Utilities Industry, and I'd like to welcome our presenters and Kelly. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Lisa. Hello, everyone. My name is Kelly Service, and as Lisa mentioned, I head Wipro's North American Utilities Marketing Team. Thank you for joining us today. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Wipro, we are a publicly traded global information technology consulting and outsourcing company with over 170,000 employees. Wipro's utilities business unit has executed over 15 business transformation programs around the world and has over 3,500 experienced professionals supporting over 25 major utilities companies. We are happy to be attending CS Week 2016 this year, and I invite you to come and visit us at our booth to learn more about Wipro's utility solutions. I'd like to briefly introduce today's presenters. Rajpal Gohar is Wipro's Senior Practice Partner for Utilities, and Dipen Abraham, who's Wipro's Senior Domain Consultant for Utilities. Rajpal has over 20 years of experience working in large-scale transformation and capability development programs across North America, the UK, Australia, and Norway. An expert in new technology solutioning, including digital analytics and cloud, Rajpal has been helping utilities companies evolve across their entire business spectrum for more than 16 years. Dipen has 11 years of process consulting and industry experience with utilities in North America, the UK, Australia, and Turkey. He has been helping utilities companies define and integrate digital innovation solutions in support of business transformation projects for utility clients in both regulated and deregulated markets. Gentlemen, I'll now pass control over to you.
Thank you, Kelly. Good afternoon, everyone, and maybe good morning for some. This is Rajpal Gohar. As Kelly introduced me, I am the Senior Practice Partner from Wipro Technologies. In today's slide, we are going to talk about the digital trends in utility industry, and we are going to talk about some of the opportunities there. So today, we start the session with utilities industry context and trends, get into the opportunities, and going digital, some examples how we can leverage the digital economy better for the utility industry. So I'll start with the utilities industry context and trends. Till now, if you see in last 30 years, I think digital had been the biggest disruption. Probably first 20 years in last 30 years, the utility industry tended to be very reactive to the customer. The trigger points were different for customer engagement. Mostly it was a supply disruption, which used to lead to a customer to call the utility industry and to fix the problem. Or it was like moving home, moving and move out, which are the common scenarios, or complaints and inquiries in general about the bills or anything else. So those were the typical touch points, and they were all reactive. Moving on, in today's world, if we see, we are moving to a very proactive kind of communication with the customer. The consumer behavior has drastically changed. So in the next slide, we have listed some of the new trends in the changing industry. So one of the trends which is there is about number of channels which have increased. So the channel of communication, at least there are 8 to 10 different kind of channels which are available, including voice, web chat, SMS, and mobile apps. If you see the way we talk to customers has increased like anything. And influencing of choices that consumer make, that is what is the thing which every industry aspire in today's world. So now the trend has gone to now utilities are not a customer service agent only. They are looking at become a trusted advisor for the customer in terms of additional services are being sold to the customer, and they have different kind of plans. And as I said, the channel of communications are more proactive. One of the trend obviously is, and there are many trends, energy efficiency is one of the key themes for the consumers. So slowly what we are seeing as a trend is that the power and gas bills are becoming almost 10 to 15% of typical household consumption. And that is a significant amount. So consumers are also paying a huge attention to what bill they are paying to utility companies, including all three services, gas, electric, and water. And most of the time, utility industry today is actually adopting a retail kind of customer engagement. And when I say retail, there is a lot on data analytics, how we engage with the customer, how is the first interaction with the customer going to happen. So one thing which we are seeing that as an opportunity is that digital is able to make difference in all these aspects. And there are a number of opportunities that emerge. So moving on to the next slide. If you see today's world, we are moving from traditional to digital world. And welcome to the world where customer now is engaged in so many different channels, and if you see, people are actually using number of smartphones. They are using Google searches. They are going to Amazon.com to see the latest trend. So if you see, the customer benchmarks are quite high, and they are looking for same kind of experience in utility industry in their interactions. And if you see, the world has moved towards more 24/7 channels. And as a utility company, we all understand managing the customer service operation for 8 to 9 hours a day itself was a challenge. And 24/7 is a new challenge to the utility industry. Other thing is customers are looking for a lot of flexibility in the delivery models and how the product and services are offered to them. And the other trend, good or bad, is that all the news or all the information travels quite fast. All the customers are active in social channels, and we have seen more often than not the negative news or the bad news actually travels much faster than the positive one. And there are real-time point of views which are confirmed, denied, or shared. So we are in a changing paradigm, where your consumers are completely connected. And the other challenge is that while the digital age is going on, the traditional channels are still quite potent, and there is a segment of customers which tends to interact on the traditional channels as well. So at least this trend has given that the how you manage different kind of channels and how you can be cost effective as well as impactful the customer is a base challenge which we are trying to address today. Moving on to the next slide. One of the key trends in digital, if you see, this is a connected world. So we have tried to depict the image of how a smart home looks like today. You have a smart home in which the number one, and I am just going through the stars which are represented out there. There is interval data or smart meters, events and alerts which are coming in. So the amount of data which is pouring into the utility industry is quite huge. Apart from the metering data, there are complex billing, payments and collection data which is coming through. there are a number of smart devices within the home. So there are devices which range from actually your thermostats to the data. There are smart devices which can actually control remotely your devices. There is a trend of distributed generation, and typically this trend we see more in West Coast where there is good amount of adoption has happened on the solar side. So not only the solar panels, so you are talking about some micro generation sites as well. So number of places you have to do the settlement with the grid. There are number of energy efficiency programs utility companies are running depending on the geo and the situation. And there are number of ways we are interacting with the consumer on a remote connect, disconnect basis. So smart home is actually becoming quite complex, and the amount of data it generates for the utility and the amount of interaction it creates for the utility in this company is huge. But at the same time, there are huge amount of potential to that as well. Moving on to the next slide. So here, when we talk about business opportunities, we are seeing that now there is a world where utility industry are actually important ingredient of what is happening in the household. So you are able to get a lot of information about the smart home, about the company, about how the user behavior is there. And according to that, there is a lot of cross-sell and upsell opportunities. So we have seen examples where a utility company is able to sell very impactfully the insurance products. And no wonder, like if you put a solar panel and a battery combination provided by utility industry, you are able to sell the insurance product because it actually gives you a point where you are able to sell some of the services like insurance or some additional services there. We have seen utility companies selling normal household service right from the plumbing work to some of the advising kind of things on the demand side management. So there are, this world is actually getting very well connected, but the good news for utility industry is that there is enough opportunity for cross-sell and upsell in this environment. And the number of channels which we have, so although there is an increase in channels, but at the same time there is an increase in opportunity because these channels are quite potent and customers are very actively listening to these channels. So in real time, you can do cross-sell and upsell. So in the competitive patches in United States, you can see people are running web campaigns quite impactfully, and number of move-in and move-out transactions have started to move in there. Moving on to the next slide. Today, actually, I am just going to talk about some of the opportunities in digital economy and what kind of solution which are emerging as part of this economy. And there are three solutions which we have listed there. On the left side, you can see business drivers for the utility company, typically which are determined by huge expenditure on CIS systems. But the opportunity side, if you see, there is CIS as a service which is available. So till in last 5 years, I think cloud and PaaS solution, platform as a service or as a service solution in general, were talked about a lot, but it has become reality now. So if you have seen, and you all are quite well connected, from last year onwards, there are credible services which have come on CIS as a service. As a matter of fact, Wipro also launched CIS as a service last year, which is based on Oracle customer care and billing solution, a tier one billing solution. And good news there is that CIS as a service team, when you look at the OPEX and CAPEX pattern, you are actually reducing the cost to serve market by 50% at least, which is a big opportunity. We have seen on the business driver side once again that smart meters and mobile-based users are actually getting very active in the sensor world. So similar side, we have also launched, and there are a number of solutions, not only Wipro, many other companies have launched self-service solutions And good news there is that you can now write code once, and it supports all kind of smart devices, including the portals, webs there. So you can use techniques like HTML5 or UI5 in different platforms, where you can actually code once, and it is able to intelligently understand that which device customer is connected to, and it will actually dynamically change the view. So if a customer is connected to a mobile device, it will shrink the view to fit in the mobile device. So that is that kind of opportunity. And there are different digital platforms on the business driver side, and there is a solution point of view. We have launched digital customer experience, which is actually dealing with the complete life cycle of customer journey, right from customer move in and move outs to how their behavior on the social media is and how we can launch a active campaign for them. So these are the kind of solutions which we are going to talk about a little bit in detail in next few slides. Moving on to the next slide. So why CIS as a service? So that is the question which is a natural question everyone would ask. So CIS, if you see, one of the key thing in CIS is was the biggest spend area, and almost like there is a up to $4 billion spent per year on the in North American market alone. From the smart, there is actually a lot of play. If you see, the traditional utility had been working on legacy platforms, or maybe they went to ERPs like SAPs, Oracles, or MECOMs of the world, but still they were not able to get to the right digital media, and they were not able to penetrate the market where they were able to interact customers through digital media. And there is big amount of still, when we say tier 2 and tier 3 utility, it is in terms of customer segment numbers. There are number of utilities which is like half a million mark or less than half a million. They were not able to get into tier 1 product segment. And again, the risk in CIS implementation, as many of you would know from the data, we know that 30% of the CIS implementations failed to deliver on time and on budget. And many times they failed significantly, that it took number of years to correct the system. So that is where actually utilities were looking for a flexibility where they can get the best of breed CIS solution, state of the art technology at low price, adoption to the digital, reduce the risk and effort, and move from CapEx to OpEx model. This is actually extremely important part. The thing is that CIS as service, what happens is that utility can model it in any way. You can have a model in which you pay CapEx and then your OpEx becomes very, very low, or other way around, you can be completely on an OpEx-based model, and you can actually do something in between. So that is the CIS as a service offers a lot of flexibility to the customer, how your budgets are and what your current financial positions are. According to that, you can take decision whether you want to go for a OPEX-led model or a CAPEX model completely. Moving on to the next slide. Here, what is the value proposition from CIS as a service? So I'll quickly talk through because and I'll not read all the messages in the slide here. So we are actually looking at cost saving of up to 50%. That is the biggest advantage of CIS as a service, and it is proven into multiple customer places now. And other thing is that you can reduce your implementation cost and your OPEX cost to something like a dollar figure, dollar per meter per month kind of figure, quite easy. The thing is that from a service offering point of view, how it works is that you can do the quick implementation, and you will have essentially in this one, you get a pre-configured CIS as a service solution in which you have to migrate your data and maybe do some basic rules configuration which are very unique to your company. And then you are actually, you don't pay for anything like annual maintenance cost for software or hardware. You are actually on a pay-per-price basis. So you can decide on your model and you can pay a dollar figure per month per meter basis on the basis of that. And what at the base of this platform, what Wipro offering is offering you is a TL1 solution, Oracle CCNB, and this is backed by the rapid deployment templates, which is pre-configured rules for water, gas, and electricity in North America. You have all the data centers in North America, so there are various options you can choose from. So there are at least 8 to 9 choices across the United States which exist where you can decide on your data center. And can be actually extended to a business process as a service as well. So CIS as a service is a complete IT solution. But if you want some of the work like back office processing to be bundled along with it, that is quite possible in this offering. Moving on to the next slide. And the solution is quite comprehensive. So what you can see is that it caters to all possible integration and exchanges which a typical utility companies provide. Don't go by the complexity of this diagram. It is just showing that kind of interactions utility companies will have with their CIS systems. Everything comes as a all for say payment gateway kind of interfaces. Everything is ready-made interface and connection is there, and those are pre-configured. So it is more plug-and-play kind of solution for you, right from your email linkages to your payment gateways, your interfaces with the industry, your meter read agents. Everything is pre-configured in this solution. Moving on to the next slide. Here I'll request Jipin to come over and speak quickly through the web and mobile part. Jipin.
Thanks, Rajpal. Yeah, thank you very much. So hello, everybody. My name is Jipin Ibrahim. I'm a domain consultant within the utilities portfolio, and I've had the chance to work for more than 10 years consulting for utilities, and my focus area typically is in the digital innovation. That being said, so essentially what I wanted to speak to you about, given the fact that we are talking about the digital roadmap for utilities, so one of the areas that you know utilities have tended to focus on is web self-serve, right? But if you look at this infographic, most of that has tended to be, at least on the web self-serve, it tended to be fairly basic, the theory being that you know, we want to give customers the ability to view their bills, to be able to pay bills, and to do all that's basically necessary to keep the lights on. Right. So that has been the thinking. As far as mobile is concerned, there has been little or no mobile presence, apart from the fact that you know the same view and pay bills facility has been extended to a mobile. Beyond that, there has hardly been any apps or anything of that sort which utilities have tended to invest in. The fact today is, you know, there are more mobile devices on Earth than there are people, so that is a fact. So utilities need to shift as far as their typical mindset has been in terms of just me giving them a mobile front end for essentially what is a web self-serve. On the web self-serve part, what we are seeing is typically the self-service does not encompass the end-to-end customer journey. Now, what we mean by customer journey is a customer being able to not just view and pay bills, but to be able to do everything that the customer would have done on a call center or any of the traditional channels, right? So what we recommend, or what you know, the way forward is to slowly bridge the gap, and from a basic capability for utilities to be able to provide differentiating or leading web self-serve. And as far as the mobile is concerned, you know, we're talking about moving the customer along in terms of you know, having none to basic capability to have enhanced capability. Just the fact is, you know, we mentioned earlier about the consumer, right, expecting the omnipresence of Google and the experience that the customer gets using products like, you know, the Apple products or the Amazons of the world. The other fact is, it's the same consumer that we are dealing with, right? So I think in the digital economy, the customer is not going to differentiate whether it's a utility company that I'm dealing with, is it a telecom company that I'm dealing with, or is it a retail company that I'm dealing with. So essentially, the offering from a utility company has to evolve, and that's what you know, we have depicted in this particular slide. I will just go through it in slightly more detail in the next slide. So this is the typical value proposition that we can offer, and what utilities are asking in today's day and age. Now, the first, if you look on the left-hand side, essentially, it's a customer self-serve website, right? And the major objective of that website, from a customer perspective, is to view their relationship with utilities, to view information about their accounts, view their account, outstanding balance, bills, etc., make payments. So these are all, to some extent, it's mostly been covered, right? Come down to the next one, which is user authentication and authorization. Typically, this also, most of the self-serve portals tend to provide. And then the service enablement aspect is when customers can create service requests online and essentially be able to complete their entire move-in and move-out process online, just the way that they would do with the help of a customer call center agent. Now, what really differentiates, right, or moves the bar as far as the utility is concerned, is the last bit, where the entire life cycle of a customer can be managed via a portal. And this has to be done in a way that is intuitive, right? For example, can you enable a search-like feature, like a customer who's used to a Google search, for example, right? When you type in a keyword about something, the Google search engine actually prompts you to figure out what that search could be. Can some of those features be extended on a utilities portal, whether you're searching for an address or whether you want help with some sort of request, right, from an agent of some sort. So can that be automated, and can that be brought online? So those are the features that, some of them which we have enabled on Wipro's Easy Self-Serve, right? So, and the other aspect is, for example, how easy can we really make it for customers to use the self-serve platform. If a customer would like to sign up with you as a utility, right, is that going to be a one-minute process, or is that going to take more than 10 minutes, in which case, the customer might just give up and not do that. So what we have enabled, some of these, thoughts from a user experience perspective has been ported on to Wipro's self-serve platform. For example, enabling a simple thing like, customers saying, hey, I don't know what my service point address is. I don't know what my meter number is. But can I just, I have my mobile. Can I just, take a photograph of my previous bill from a different utility provider? And would that information alone be sufficient for you to process my move-in request? So those are some of the features that we are enabling on the Easy Self-Serve platform. And these are essentially based on feedback from what customers would like to see on their self-serve portals, right? So moving on, as far as the mobile aspect is concerned, it is not just sufficient, now to have a mobile presence. It is beyond that. What can my mobile app give me, right? Those customers are used to having access to multiple mobile apps. From utility perspective, what are the aspects that I can enable on the mobile? And essentially, it comes down to the same things. Can I perform move-in and move-out? Can I offer the right plans and offers? Consumption trends, can I display to the customer, apart from a bill payment, CSAT surveys? Can I link the social profile of my customer and ensure that some amount of insights I can draw from that and I can use that for social networking, right? So these are the aspects that need to be considered in the mobile. And mobile can be a fairly, it can be a simple process. Or there are multiple aspects to enabling a mobile app, but it's essentially about the factors we spoke about earlier on in the presentation. It's about simplicity, it's about omnipresence, it's about the digital experience, right? So these are the themes that we are seeing both in the mobile as well as in the web space. Moving on, the other aspect that, in the digital economy that utilities need to consider, right, is about how effectively you are able to listen to customer conversations, right? Analyze those conversations or interactions and engage with the customer in a channel of their choice. Now, there was this classic sort of example of a customer who was whose luggage was misplaced by a leading airline company, right? And you know, the customer tweets about that and asks the airline company about how soon can you know, can the customer expect the baggage to be retrieved. And the airline company responds, in all fairness to the customer, saying that our social media account, you know, about our handle just works from 9 to 5. And that got tweeted, you know, a few hundred times. But then the customer does not give up and says, how can the, you know, how can an airline company that is essentially a 24/7 business only have a 9 to 5 social media support? And that gets tweeted a few thousand times more. So essentially, customers today have the power to make and break brands. Right. So in that sense, utilities are not, you know, sort of an island or cut off from the rest of the world. So the same customer who is tweeting about the airline company not doing anything as far as helping the customer online with the lost baggage, the same customer could be talking about the experience that he or she had with maybe a, you know, a move-in process or a bill payment process or you know, or any of these standard processes, but in an online world, right? So on the, that is on the consumer side. On the other side of the on the spectrum, we have a plethora of data that is getting generated, right? We know that smart meters have disrupted the market, and there are a lot of insights that can be got from the wealth of data that gets generated from these devices. So I guess the challenge that falls from a utility perspective is, on the one hand, I have more data than I ever had about the customer, right? How can I meaningfully use that data? On the other side, how can I engage with the customer, given that the customer is engaged in multiple forums and in multiple channels? So if you just look at the slide, I'm on slide 22, I hope that's visible in front of you. So the listen part does not just relate to, you know, listening to what a customer is saying on your Facebook page, right? Today's technology has evolved, and certainly there are solutions out there that we promote as well. So you should be, from a utility perspective, you should be able to listen to your customer, irrespective of, you know, what is the forum that the customer wishes to engage in, right? And in an ideal world, there shouldn't be limitations about how much of data comes in from those channels or what form factor those channels are. And for example, is it a voice interaction that I'm trying to track? Is it a social media post that I'm trying to track? Is it some sort of a video or a YouTube video which the customer has spoken about me as a company, which I need to listen in? So that really the channel becomes immaterial. The ability for the utility should be to really garner that you know, customer insights irrespective of channel. The second aspect is analyze. Now, given that, you know, utility has the ability now with the technologies available to be able to listen in on customer conversations. How can I analyze that data and not just, you know, analyze the typical CRM data that I used to analyze in the past? Can I generate meaningful insights from some of these social conversations? And it doesn't end there. Can I, after having listened and analyzed, can I as a utility engage those customers? You know, maybe the customer is not expecting the utility to engage, right? But proactively, can I act on what I've heard the customer speaking? Can I connect with that customer? And can I promote campaigns to customers depending on the situation in which the customer is in, right? So this is the background. And for this, what Wipro offers essentially is, you know, the digital customer experience management platform. Where, you know, like I mentioned a little while earlier, the channels become immaterial. It could be social channels that we are listening in on. And this is publicly available information, by the way. So there is no, you know, there are no privacy laws that we are defaulting on, right? So this public available information on social channels, And obviously from a utility standpoint, you have enterprise data available where probably the same customers who are talking about their experience on social channels have probably engaged with the utility in traditional channels of calling up the call center. Now, is there a way possible that you can marry this information, right? The same customer who probably called up the call center and said, hey, can you resolve it? Did not receive a resolution, but went back to a social channel to complain about that. Can I tie these two information together? And can I provide the service in a better manner to the end customer? So that's what the channel provides. There's analysis that we do on products, on brands, on customer types, et cetera. And from publicly available information, it's also possible now to compare what competitors or customers of competitors are saying about essentially what could be a similar sort of a process. For example, how do I rate how my billing process works, or how customers perceive the simplicity of the billing process to be how can we compare, essentially, is what I'm saying, using publicly available information. So what the platforms of today can do, and Wipro certainly has offerings in this space, is, okay, after having done the analysis of the product, of the brand, what customers are saying regarding my billing process or my payment process or my discounts and plans, what is a similar profile of a customer who's not my customer but a customer of a competing utility? Right, what are they saying in a similar manner? Is there any lesson that I can learn from there? And having analyzed the customer interactions, is it possible now for me to segment those customers and generate leads on them and integrate with a campaign management platform? So that's the sort of the closed loop that we're talking about, which is insights to action. And the platform, from a Wipro perspective, is digital customer experience platform that can do all of the listen, analyze, engage, act, as well as promote. So what this provides is not just the standard reactive sort of campaigns that one is typically used to and has done in the past, but being able to predict what the customer experience is likely to be given a particular situation. And to take action well before the event. So that's the value proposition as far as Wipro is concerned. I really just want to spend a couple of minutes more on a recent example of a utility, right, who underwent digital transformation, and Wipro was the digital transformation partner as far as that utility was concerned. It's a leading utility retailer in Australia, with more than 4 million end customers. And Australia is one of the most competitive markets as far as utility retailing is concerned. And just a background here is that this particular utility was not lacking a sophisticated CRM system or a billing system. They were using a tier one billing and CRM system, but the digital transformation was something which was undertaken for the following key objectives. Number one, for a streamlined, efficient, and a quick time to market for all aspects of digital content and communication. From a utility perspective, even if you have a tier one or a leading CIS product, what some utilities find is that the time taken to roll out a campaign, or the time to market as far as a campaign is concerned, tends to be long, given that there are agencies involved, there are back and forth as far as campaign collaterals are concerned, there are multiple prospect or customer sets that needs to be worked through. So essentially, there is a lag time, or there is a lead time associated with getting that campaign off the ground, right? So one of the asks from the customer was, can I have a streamlined, efficient way and a quick time to market for all aspects of digital content communications? Can I roll out, can I reduce the cost of asset production, revision, management? Is there a way to manage this multiple versions and the back and forth between the agencies and the utility? From a business perspective, every time I want to make a change to a campaign collateral, And especially if it's a campaign that I want to run in an online platform, is there a way that I can see exactly what I'm going to get? Can I be able to input onto that campaign in an almost real-time basis and deliver or develop once, publish everywhere sort of a methodology wherein I want to be able to see how exactly it looks like on a tablet. I want to be able to see how it looks on a mobile and how it looks like on a traditional desktop or a laptop, right? How can I automate the content targeting across segments, individual devices, and how can I enhance the whole effectiveness of the campaign itself, right? So this was the broad ask from the marketing organization, and what Wipro developed over a period of a time is essentially multiple things, right? So one is we tend to approach it from a top down. Firstly, from a strategic perspective, the experience that we give to the customer at the end of the day has to be engaging, has to be relevant, timely, omni-channel, and there has to be a call to action, right? And the touch points are multiple, and we have and there was a conscious aspect within the digital transformation that irrespective of the touch point, we needed to really engage with the customer on all and every touch point as far as the channel is concerned, right? It could be a portal that the customer is coming onto. It could be via an app. It could be via microsites that are created on the website. It could be traditional correspondence, or it could be social. And from a platform perspective, you want a platform, right, that supports all of your business processes. Now, you need what we call is the digital asset management. So in order to improve the time to market, you essentially need a store for all of your digital assets, your videos, all of your artwork, right? They have to be managed. They have to be versioned. They have to be consistent. They have to be, there has to be a proper authorization, authentication mechanism for any changes that happen to these assets. You have the whole web experience management aspect, enterprise content management, customer communications, and obviously integration with the backend CRM and billing. Now, all of this was delivered on a leading platform from Adobe, right, for this particular customer. But essentially, Wipro has gone beyond being dependent on a particular product vendor, and we have open source options as well, not just for digital customer experience management, but also for web's online self-serve. So from adoption perspective, it's much more easier for utility companies. And this is one example of Australian retailer, but we have had the, we have worked with retailers in North America as well, enabling, a digital transformation. So essentially, during the course of this short webinar, what we have sort of tried to cover is, number one, what are the key opportunities out there? What are the key trends out there that utilities are seeing or are likely to see in the future? What are the solutions, that probably will need to be augmented or will need some sort of, there will be traction on some of the solutions that we have spoken about, and we've taken three examples. One is CIS as a service. One is enhanced web and mobile self-serve beyond what is being offered currently. And the third one is obviously, the credentials that Wipro brings to the table with respect to work we have done both for North American utilities as well as for utilities across the globe. So with that, I think from a the slide perspective or the presentation material perspective, I would just like to pause and probably use the next 10 to 15 minutes that we have to get questions and to hear feedback in terms of is there any aspect that that the audience would like further information on. Over to you, Kelly.
Well, thank you, Dipan and Rajpal. If any of the attendees have any questions, For our presenters, you can submit them using the Q&A panel located at the right of your screen. You can send them to us, and I can relay the questions. We have a couple here right now. So to Rajpal or Dipen, what are some of the benefits of a subscription-based CIS model?
Kelly, this is Raj. So from my perspective, the biggest advantage which I see for utilities companies that huge amount of opportunity. You can model your CapEx and OpEx in a way which is conducive to you. So as I said during the discussion, you can have a model in which you can be very dominated by CapEx. If you have capital expenditure in hand, you can use that model, or you can go towards a complete OpEx-based model. So it provides an enormous amount of flexibility, and obviously the price tag is almost like 50%. So if you compare a life cycle of a normal implementation versus CIS as a service, the price, total cost of ownership in a 5-year to 7-year horizon is less than 50% from the traditional model. So cost bargain, the flexibility in the pricing, and third thing is that you reduce a lot of expenditures from the normal IT services perspective, because end-to-end services provided as a complete platform, application management, day-to-day support is completely bundled in the service. So you don't have to incur any other expenses to run this IT operation. So those are the three advantages I would call out are the biggest ones, apart from others.
Okay. Thank you very much. There's another question here. What are some of the ways a digital customer experience can be applied?
Hi, Kelly. So this is Dipen again. Maybe I'll take that question. So essentially what we're seeing is, you know, the whole digital, from a digital customer experience, you know, use case perspective, one is to be able to garner more customer insights. So essentially what the platforms and solutions are providing are insights as a service, and I explained that briefly during the presentation earlier. So what are my customers, you know, speaking about me as a utility company? You know, what are the insights that I can gain from that in order to engage my customer better? So I guess the first use case would be proactive customer insights. The other end of the spectrum is also how can I, you know, using the, you know, advanced analytics models, can I apply that for some sort of predictive analytics, right? For example, you know, how likely is a particular customer subset likely to churn, right? You know, what are the reasons why they're likely to churn, right? What are the trigger points for that? So these events are something which, you know, we can definitely not just listen and analyze, but also be able to respond in the you know, preferred choice of customer channels as well. So definitely one is the whole customer insights aspect, which you know utilities can use to then figure out a better way of dealing with the customers and engaging with customers. The second is there could be multiple use cases, especially on the predictive side of things. Propensity to churn is one classic example, and there are a few others as well. So this is these are some of the ways, I guess, that a digital customer experience can be applied for a utility company.
Perfect. Thank you, Dipen. We have one more question here so far. Again, if anybody wants to send any more questions, please do. The next question is, how long would it take to implement a cloud-based CIS solution?
I'll take that, Kelly. This is Raj once again. So that is actually very important aspect of CIS as a service solution. So it is not going to be a traditional model. So typically traditional model of CIS implementation, what we are used to is that we go through a blueprinting phase, we go through a realization phase, a long testing phase. We have flipped it over to the other side. In this model, a CIS implementation can range between 6 months to 12 months for a company. So essentially the focus is on migrating the data from the existing legacy system to CIS platform. And we don't ask a question of doing blueprinting. We show the demonstration to the business users, how the system looks like, what are the features configured, and they are able to choose some flexibilities. So obviously in the template-based model, say we have applied, provided certain rate categories and certain rates calculation. If they want to modify or include some additional product and service, they can very well do that one. And after that, this is a completely tested solution. So testing lifecycle is not about doing a lot of integration testing and this one. We start directly with user acceptance testing kind of this one. So there will be minor solution integration testing depending on your customization. So for a small company which is like 100,000 meters or 150,000 meters, the implementation can practically be achieved in 6 months. But for an average middle-sized utility for a 500,000 meter kind of thing, the period could be in the range of 9 to 12 months.
Thank you very much. We do have another question here. What are some examples of utilities with good self-service web and mobile capabilities? Are there any lessons we can learn from them?
Yeah, so maybe I'll just attempt to answer that question, Kelly. So, so like we mentioned in one of the earlier infographics, right? So utilities, from an average utility, what the mobile presence is, and from an average utility perspective, what the web presence is. There are examples of utilities who are not looking at other utilities. To define how their web and mobile channels are, so utilities now are taking a more sort of a retail centric sort of approach, right? And again, I mentioned earlier about how a simple search like function, right? It's just a simple example how a search like function can be enabled for a mobile or a web-based self-serve solution. From a mobile perspective, the one of the aspects that needs to be considered is how cognitive can I make that platform, right? The moment you have access to the customer, you can garner much more information about the customer's lifestyle, right? For example, right, and that information can be used to design value add products. Like for example, is a customer likely to watch movies? Is the customer likely to read a lot of books? So this sort of information, lifestyle information, typically can be tied in with some of their social profile information. And that information can be used to actually design products for customers. And we are seeing some of the leading utilities actually going beyond the traditional utility offerings of gas or water or electricity, and providing these value-add solutions to customers, not as a hit-or-miss solution, but based on feedback that they have garnered from the social profile of customers.
So let me add a couple of points to it. So from learning perspective, what we are seeing, and typically as a consulting company, what we learn from is from very competitive markets. So markets like UK and Australia, which have been deregulated for a long time, I think they are the best examples to take from. And from web self-service and mobile capability point of view, one of the points which Dipin highlighted, that program it once, and it should be sufficient for all kind of interactions, this one. So if you are writing a web page, it should be sufficient for the web portal interaction. It should be sufficient for mobile device or a iPad kind of device and different operating systems. So there are technologies available and which are quite simple to do. So I think do it once is one of the key learnings from there. And second thing is that I think digital or these channels are all about lifestyle. So if we can give that intuitive feel, what people see typically in a Facebook or Amazon or a Google, and give those kind of features back to customer, they tend to utilize the web channel more than anything. So one word of caution is that many times, and this is one of the best practice, that many times people try to hurry into a web channel implementation. But one thing about web which is very risky is that the first impression is the last impression. Typically, customers, if they have a bad experience once on website, they never tend to visit again. So I think taking some time and saying that what all features we are going to provide and they are going to be, how good they are going to be the customer, there is some thinking process required. And I think a diligent approach is required from that perspective. So those will be three best practices I would like to comment on.
All right. Well, thank you very much. And that's it for the questions. We don't have any others in the queue, so I'll pass it back over to Lisa.
Well, thank you very much. That was a very informative and very valuable presentation. We thank you for joining us today. We have just a couple of quick notes before we sign off. Registration, as mentioned earlier, is open for Conference 40 in Phoenix, and early registration ends March 1st. So we would definitely encourage you to visit our website and sign up as quick as you can. And also, we invite you to join us next month on March 15th at 2 p.m. Eastern for our next Marketplace webinar featuring EY and Arizona Public Service on their transformational journey. You can register from our website, csweek.org. And again, I just wanted to say thank you, Kelly, Raj, and Dipen, that we enjoyed this, and we are looking forward to seeing you at CS Week.